السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد My dear respected brothers and sisters, all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, our Savior, our Cherisher, our Nourisher, and the only entity entitled to worship. We send our most choicest of salutations upon our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his noble companions, upon his pure household, upon each and every one of us until the Day of Judgment. My believing brothers and sisters, Eid is that celebration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us in devotion and in lieu of our practices that we engaged in the month of Ramadan. Allah says beautifully in the Quran, He asks a very beautiful question. He says,
قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ
Allah actually emphasizes a beautiful point. He says that say, O Prophet of Allah, to the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it is by the virtue of Allah and His mercy that people should be happy. It is more better than any monetary aspect that they can accumulate. My believing brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, many of us worked diligently and hard in the month of Ramadan. We went to the Taraweeh prayers and our days were sacrificed in hunger and fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We dedicated our charities to those who are less fortunate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he beautifully says in this respect, that لِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَان فَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ That for the fasting person, there's two forms of happiness. One is during their iftar. Iftar can mean the time we sit down after Maghrib, breaking our fast, or iftar can also mean the Eid day, where we're not fasting today in celebration. And then, this is the first happiness. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the second happiness is when they meet their Maker. Allahu Akbar, have we ever thought of what this hadith means, my friends? Have we ever thought and reflected upon what is the meaning of true happiness on the day of Eid? That mashallah, tabarakallah, in the month of Ramadan, we diligently worshipped through prayer and salah. We were able to do sujood. We were able to prostrate to Allah. With concentration and devotion, we stood. With love and humbleness, we bowed. With genuinity and devotion, did we make sujood. The secret behind this is that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always keep us able, always keep us moving and in afiyah to pray in a manner where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with us. In the month of Ramadan, my friends, we gave zakah for the sake of Allah. In that likely manner, we understand through this action of giving zakah, what happiness do we achieve? That ya Allah, just as we indulged in giving zakah, just as we engaged in executing zakah, please leave your phones alone, jazakum Allahu khairan. Just as we engaged in giving zakah, that oh Allah, you continue to shower us with your bounties unconditionally and endlessly in this world and when we meet you. That just as we gave, ya Allah, you give us as well. Give us that happiness that many people have lost. Many a times wealth is not just monetary gain. Sometimes despite having every dollar and penny in your pocket, you're not happy. That happiness is from the Almighty Allah. That happiness in the sight of the Almighty Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is contentment. Happiness is just a phase. Being content is true, genuine happiness. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. That whoever from among the men or the women equally does good deeds, they are good in their life, they don't harm anyone, Allah will grant them a pure life. What is better than having that pure life, my friends? A pure life, let me give it to you over here by saying, even in days of distress, even in days of anxiety and depression, you're able to make it through. And you're still thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is true happiness. Because you know that there's only endless goodness waiting for you in the hereafter. My beloved brothers and sisters, in the month of Ramadan, we fasted. We cut ourselves from food and drink and halal pleasures with our spouses from the break of dawn till dusk. On the day of Eid, all of these items and measures are halal for us. In other words, we are saying that, O Allah, just as you provided for us the ability to enjoy food and drink endlessly and aimlessly, the ability to enjoy the companionship of our spouses on the day of Eid, aimlessly and endlessly, just as we have family and household, inshallah, aimlessly, purposefully, actually, and endlessly, that Ya Allah, you make these blessings upon us eternal. And this is true happiness, understanding this philosophy. And then on the day of judgment, where you have all of these above, from Allah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, as Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala beautifully mentions in Surah Yasin, that directly Allah will be saying, As-salamu alaykum to you. Salamun qawlam min Rabbir Rahim. That once you see that on that day, then there's no end to a particular happiness that you'll feel at that moment and at that juncture. No end. Infinite and beyond infinite. And that is why today we say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. My believing brothers and sisters, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. That you finish this particular days of fasting that Allah has facilitated for you, and you glorify Allah above all based on this devotion that you were able to do, and you show the utmost genuine thanks to Allah. This is the sifat and the simt of the believer. This is the quality and the mark of a believer. That even in their worldly gain, or their worldly success, or even in their religious success, or spiritual success, even in the worldly investments, if it's a plus, or the religious investments, you're able to do much good deeds. If it's a plus, we don't attribute as believers anything to ourselves. No bragging rights, except Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises are due to Allah, who gave us the ability to do what we did. Yes, we can feel happy for what we engaged in, but praise is only for the Master, for Allah, the Almighty, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Because if He did not give you the mobile ability to do what you did, how would you do what you did? If He did not give you, in one way or the other, the wealth to sacrifice and give to others, how would you give? Hence, that is why we start in all of our prayers, and we start our day with saying, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, that all praises are due to Allah, the Lord of the Universe. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. My believing brothers and sisters, of course it's a day of happiness, but it is befitting at times to mention serious sadnesses that the Ummah is facing. We are at this juncture where we are at a personal level, so broken. Every family has an issue. Every family has an issue. When will we rectify our situations? When will we be the believers that Allah described us to be in the Quran? How does Allah describe us? Do you know? In the 10th juz of the Holy Quran, beautifully mentioned the categorization and the description of the believing men and the believing women. What does Allah say? Allah says,
وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أُولَئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ.
Allah describes you as allies of one another, friends and beloveds of one another. The believing men and the believing women, they are assisters, allies, and friends of one another. And that motivates them to enjoin goodness and forbid evil. And that motivates them to conduct their activities in a diligent manner. يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ, they establish the prayer in their lives. They're connected with the Maker, and hence, because of the mercy of the Maker, they're connected with everyone else. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ, they fulfill the alms to humanity. If they're fulfilling one obligatory part, then inshallah they're fulfilling all the other voluntary and obligatory parts that they need to fulfill in reference to humanity. And what is their biggest sifah at the end? Unconditionally yuti'oon Allah wa Rasulah. They obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and the Messenger said don't break hearts, then they don't break hearts. If Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, if He said that don't backbite and don't cheat, they don't cheat and backbite. Try to get along with people, join connections. They will make sure that they join connections, even if it is by means of assalamu alaykum and wa alaykum assalam. How are you, my brother? How are you, my sister? You can't converse beyond that. You don't get along with the guy. At least something. That you leave this world in a manner that you don't have any grudges in your heart against anybody, you know, and they don't have any grudges against you. That you live like the human being, which is, once again, the definition of human being, just by the lafz of it, the kalima of it, is uns. Insan comes from uns. That we show that compassion to one and all, and we can't live without compassion. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Along with this, let us not forget all of those who are hungry, all of those who are suffering either by natural disasters or man-made calamities, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitates ease for them. May they be unjustly imprisoned, or may they be under bombs and bullets. May they be under evil political regimes. May they be under evil people in society. That Allah makes it easy for all of these people and removes their troubles and difficulties. And in that likely manner, along with making dua for them, may they be, wherever they may be, in the land of Palestine or in the land of Kashmir, which have been suffering for endless ages, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, facilitates ease for them. In recent days, Sudan, may Allah facilitate ease in Sudan. You know, all the places, people always say, you didn't name my country. The countries are too many to name. May it be Lebanon or India or Pakistan or Afghanistan or Masr or Pakistan or Sri Lanka, wherever, Africa, various places. May it be Jordan, wherever people are suffering. Canada, America, England, Europe, where we are suffering at times with our own selves. Our families are broken. Ya Allah, you know, Syria, wherever they may be. Ya Allah, bring about ease for every single person. And aham shay, the most important thing in terms of your world that you can ask for is afiyah, well-being. Ya Allah, grant me perpetual well-being in my deen and in my dunya. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah fi deeni wa dunyaya wa akhirati, even in the akhirah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Understand that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's default nature was compassion. He was very compassionate. He was very forgiving. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he had the utmost tawakkul and reliance in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At one juncture, It was asked to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that what is the most beloved deed that you can do that is pleased to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is the most greatest of actions? Umar radiallahu anhu says that he was asked at one occasion, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in this narration of Tabrani, that idkhaluka surur ala mu'min, that you entering happiness upon a fellow believer. And the first and foremost recipients of this happiness, that the first and foremost recipients of this happiness should be your own very beloved, dear, near and dear ones, your family members. So make sure, as a point of advice, not a point of obligation, that we try to do something very special for them on the day of Eid, something that they remember. If your parents are abroad, they're not with you, give them a call, give them a heartfelt message. Subhanallah. Look for something that will, you know, that will reach the drums of their ears, and then by means of that enter their heart eternally. Say something good to another, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And you know, just by saying something good, we commit a charity. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, wal kalimatu tayyibatu sadaqa. That even a beautiful word, a good word, is charity. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Allahu akbar wa lillahi alhamd. نسأل الله تعالى العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة إنه جواد كريم بر رب رؤوف رحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. In that likely manner, as it's customary from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give that reminder, that whoever has fasted the month of Ramadan and then they follow up these fasts, sittam min Shawwal, with 6 days in Shawwal, kana kasiyam al-dahr, it's as if they have fasted for a point in time, a period of time. Subhanallah, al-dahr is so disputed in the Arabic language, it could mean eternity. And this is not impossible for Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His mercy is boundless, it is timeless, it is limitless. And hence, you know, if you fast in this diligent matter, the 6th of Shawwal, it is a very great reward. And it grants you the ability, according to one explanation, as if you fasted forever. We ask Allah to grant us these continued investments until the day of judgment, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all. Another situation that we can do is engage with one another in happiness. I know sometimes we're tired after the schedule of Ramadan, but if your children are just enjoying themselves a bit too much, or your family is enjoying themselves a bit too much, even if you're knocked out, and if even if you're asleep, and if even if you're woken up by them, don't lose your cool. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, despite as Allah describes him saying, "Inna laka fi an-nahari sabhan tawila," literally in terms of da'wah, you have a marathon to run in the morning. Despite that, the Prophet alaihi salam would catch those breaths and enjoy that free time of his. At one occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went to the masjid, and basically there were the Habasha, the Abyssinian Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they were doing their traditional, you know, dances and traditional spear archery, you know. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Aisha radiallahu anha, despite having so much of things to do, he said, "Ya Humaira, oh my beautiful spouse, oh my beautiful wife, atuhibbina an tanzurina ilayhim, do you wish to look at these people doing their tradition?" So she said, "Of course." Yes, na'am. فَأَقَامَهَا, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam let her, you know, put her, made her stand up. And then she looked from behind the shoulder of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And look at what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. He encouraged celebration. He encouraged celebration. And he said, دُونَكُمْ يَا بَنِي أَرْفَدَ لِتَعْلَمْ يَهُودْ أَنَّ فِي دِينِنَا فُسْحَ أي بُعِثْ وَإِنِّي بُعِثْتُ بِالْحَنَفِيَّةِ السَّمْحَ. That enjoy, O Banu Arfada. You know, show us your talents. Do your moves. Let the Yahud know that in our deen there's so much vastness to enjoy ourselves. Let the Yahud know that there's so much vastness in our deen to enjoy ourselves. And I've been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a natural way of life. Take this natural way of life, cherish it, make it a treasure for yourself, and bring about much goodness at a personal level and collective level by being an embodiment of the character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us goodness. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is your Eid, celebrate it to the maximum. Enjoy, eat, drink, you know, be with your family, party in a halal way, you know, travel if you have to. Do something good, right? Make sure you bring some happiness. You know, some people say, how can I be happy when this is happening in Palestine or Al-Aqsa? You should see them. They're celebrating right by Al-Aqsa as well. They're not saying, oh, this is happening to us, or this is happening to our friends in India or Kashmir. They themselves are celebrating. Why? Because it's an obligation from Allah to celebrate in the best manner. And bring those happinesses, even if it's in a pathway of thorns and darkness. Be that light for yourself and make your actions a light for others. As the Prophet ﷺ says, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ عِيدًا وَهَذَا عِيدُنَا. Everyone has a celebration. This is our celebration. نسأل الله تعالى العفو والعافية. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام خيرا ففقهه في الدين، ومن أراد بالإسلام شرا فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تنقذ المسجد الأقصى من اليهود الغاصبين. اللهم أنقذ المسجد الأقصى من اليهود الغاصبين. اللهم احفظ الحرمين الشريفين واحفظ الحرم الثالث الأقصى. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق، وأعمالنا من الرياء، وألسننا من الكذب، وأعيننا من الخيانة، فإنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن، وإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وصلاتنا وزكاتنا وسائر أعمالنا فيما مضى من الشهر الكريم. اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين، وأن تغفر لنا وترحمنا. وإذا أردت بعبادك فتنة فاقبضنا إليك غير مفتونين. اللهم انصر البلاد والعباد في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم احفظ البلاد والعباد في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم انصرنا على القوم الظالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك وعبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك وعبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربيانا صغارا. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما، واجعلنا ممن يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما. آمين 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 يا رب العالمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأهم وأتم وأعظم وأقوى وأكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. عيدكم مبارك، تقبل الله منا ومنكم، كل عام وأنتم بخير. This is the way that the Sahaba greeted by saying تقبل الله مني ومنكم. May Allah accept from us and may Allah accept from yourself. So greet your brothers and sisters and inshallah be on your way for a beautiful celebration. The second Eid will be led by Sheikh Burhan sharply at 9 bi-idhnillah. So tell your family and friends to make it for that Eid if they're going to make it. And then thereafter, the celebrations will proceed as announced. They'll have brunch in the gym, and then the dinner will take place at IFP. The dinner will take place at IFP. Brunch will take place at ICP. What time is dinner? 6 o'clock. 6:30 at Islamic Foundation of Peoria is the community dinner. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.